to study comparative public administration, is it important? And I'm saying, yes, it is very important. The first point is that comparative public administration helps to expand the horizon of public administration. What does it mean? It is needed to improve public policies and serial building in the field of public administration. So that you expand your horizon, you know what you have not been knowing. You know, they normally say that if you remain in one place without moving to other places, then you may not learn much. That's why when you compare, you are able to know a lot and you expand the horizon of public administration. Number two, it contributes to a greater understanding of administrative system functions in different countries. As you compare the administrative systems, you understand them more and how they function, which helps as you are improving your own public administration. Then it also helps to explain the common problems in various public administrations and then suggest remedies. Remedies or solutions. You look at the problems afflicting the various public administrations worldwide. You look at the challenges and then the solutions. And as a manager, you can also benchmark the remedies so that you solve your own solutions and administration becomes something very good. And this will mean progress. Then improving knowledge about other administrative systems. And also, it also helps in increasing interstate interaction. Because after comparing, it means that when you compare with another country, you can even send teams to study the administrations of those countries. And that means interaction, teamwork, and actually it improves public relations and the image of the country with other countries. Thus ushering in peace, harmony, and tranquility. Then increased international dependence of bureaucracies. It can also result into international trade. And it also helps in protection of human rights. After studying the different administrations, and you feel other countries are protecting human rights, you also feel challenged to protect your people's human rights. It also helps in disaster management, because you benchmark the best practices and you know how to mitigate disasters like floods, earthquakes. Then it helps in the trends towards co-production of research and network governance. You can, at this point, it means you can even introduce modern network governance like e-learning, like e-commerce, as a result of comparison of the different public administrations. Now let us briefly look at, we are looking at comparative public administration. Let us now look at what are the differences and similarities between public and private sectors. Let us first look at the similarities. Because similarities, differences, compare, contrast. Let us start with similarities, and that is compare. Both observe the same functions of management. Whether it is public or private, both of them have functions of management. And the functions which must be observed include planning, coordinating, staffing, communication, etc. Whether public or private, those functions exist for an organization to thrive. Both have a hierarchical chain of command. They both have a subordinate superior relationship, whereby whether public or private, there are ladders. There is the top and the bottom ladder, whereby the chain of command exists in both administrations. And also both exist to serve their clients. For private administration, the clients include shareholders. It includes the customers, the suppliers. While for public, the clients majorly are the general public. And also government is another client. Government, general public. ministers, then both apply common techniques, whether public or private. They apply common techniques like accounting, like auditing. They have audit books of accounts, like information technology. Now we are using e-learning, whether it is public or private, both use the same technique of e-learning, because we are in a new normal of COVID. It applies in private and public. Since the government closed all institutions of higher learning, then the public institutions and the private have decided to adopt the same technique. Another one is, let us now go to differences briefly. For public administration, there is absence of profit motive. Public administration actually works for the general welfare of the public. But for private, it aims at making profits. That's the aim. Private sector aims at making profits. But for public, it serves for the benefit of the general public. Now, it's in short of some services and another difference. There are some services which don't generate quick profits in the short run, that the private sector will find it hard to involve itself in, like construction of roads. But the public sector comes in to provide those services. Therefore, when I talk about essential of some services, that is the preserve of the public sector, not the private sector. The private sector wants to engage in services that generate quick profits. Public accountability is more strict with public sector than private sector. That's why at districts, they normally make budgets, pass the budgets in the councils, put everything on the notice board. Even recruitment, there must be transparency, notice board. But when it comes to private sector, someone can use methods he or she feels, because the business is, it belongs to him. He does not need to give accountability. He can give it or he may not, because it is his personal business. Then the legal framework. The legal framework is more strict than public administration. It is more strict than private administration, because public administration is guided by a strict legal framework. For instance, the PPDA Act. PPDA in full is public. It is procurement and disposal of assets act. An act is a law passed by parliament. It empowers all public officials to follow the process of procurement as they acquire goods and services. But when it comes to private sector, they can use methods of their choice, like direct procurement, whereby someone goes and directly purchases goods and services without following the whole cycle. But for public sector, they must follow the PPDA Act. Otherwise, if not, then they can be prosecuted, or they may not be on the good side of the law. That means the legal framework is more strict in the public sector than the private sector. Then the public sector has a large-scale administration compared to the private sector. It's something very huge when it comes to public sector, with a chain of command, and also red tape, bureaucratic delays. But for private sector, since they aim at making profits, there is nothing like a chain of command, red tape, because they want something to be done and they move on with their own business. Then other topics that we shall cover as we proceed, as I've already told you, will include approaches of comparison. That in comparing the different public administrations, which approaches shall we be looking at, like the normative approach, the historical approach, the ancient approach, and I will explain the meaning of each approach to use and help us to compare the different public administrations. Then we shall look at the evolution of public administration, where it started from up to now. That is the process of public administration, because public administration emerged somewhere. And that's when we shall look at topics like new public management, Previously, we had old model type of public administration, but nowadays we are adopting the new public of managing, for instance, result oriented, whereby managers now want results and offer jobs that contracts. Failure to satisfy, then the contract is terminated or is not renewed. So we shall see what is new public management. Why is it that we had old model type of public administration, but now has been repressed by the new public management? And we shall also see what is compared in public administration. We compare what is compared. We compare the different ideologies. We compare the arms of government. We everything will be looked at as we proceed. And as I've said, test online, coursework online. Therefore, members who haven't joined e-learning, I request you to join, because this is the way to go. E-learning is the way to go. We have no choice. And it is the modern of actually learning. I encourage you to join. In case you don't have the smartphones, you can even borrow. And I will always record the lectures for those ones with challenges. Otherwise, I wish you the best. God bless you. Make sure that you sanitize, put on masks so that you remain with life. Without life, you cannot study. God bless you. This